What's up, everyone? Welcome back. I'm Blake McLean, and I'm a music producer. So today I'm doing Little Mix, just a couple of little notes. So for the sake of time, just to make things a little bit easier, I'm going to be breaking this one up and the next couple into just halves. So it's not like three parts or anything like that, but it's just like part one, part two. So it just kind of makes it a little bit easier, especially for me with editing. But I'm stoked on this. Like, I've had, I can't even count how many people have asked me to do Little Mix. So this is going to be definitely very, very interesting, and I'm excited. A couple other little things. So I did start a Patreon, and it just has like extra videos. I didn't want to like overload everyone's notifications every single day with all the little extra ones. So I'm putting like a lot of those extra ones just on the Patreon. It's like $5 if you want to do it. I'd appreciate the support. It's really cool, and finally getting into like the habit of uploading regularly as well. So I got a schedule for here. Mondays are going to be full albums. Wednesdays are going to be full albums. Dogs, they bark. You know, I'm home. Let me think. Tuesdays, I believe, are just Patreon. And then I'll be doing, like, lyric videos as well on Mondays and Wednesdays, posting those to the Patreons. So I won't be breaking down the lyrics in the YouTube videos, but I'll spend, like, a lot of time re-breaking down the lyrics because that's a completely different beast in and of itself. So, and a couple other things. I'll probably post the schedule on YouTube, so please go check it out. That's about all that. So before I get started, as always, please give me a like, give me a subscribe if you enjoy the video. I'm going to put my social media up top. Please give me a follow on Instagram, Twitter, whatever you use, and send me messages, you know, just like leave comments, give me suggestions for what you want to hear, what you want to see, and we'll make it happen. Oh, one more thing. My EP is coming out in the next probably 2 weeks, so I've been filming a music video, actually two music videos, and a bunch of other stuff, so it's a lot, but I'm having fun. This is like the coolest thing ever, and I appreciate you all so much. So yeah, without further ado, let's get started. Let's go. Let's jump in. Now that I've gone through the giant laundry list of stuff. All right, so the national anthem. You can hear him.
She is a bad bitch, made up of magic, pray to the goddess. Don't break your promise. Thou shalt be faithful and honest.
That's pretty cool. Tons of layers there. Like, that's definitely more than just the five of them. You know, you put a ton of, like each one of them probably did, like, one or two doubles and then maybe a couple extra harmonies on top of that. So you end up with this, like, massive track of just nothing but stacks, which is kind of cool. And this is definitely a playoff of, like, the Lord's Prayer and the National Anthem, which is very interesting. Let's keep going, though. So, woman like me.
I always say what I'm feeling.
Alright.
I was born without a zip on my mouth. Sometimes I don't even mean it. It takes a little while to figure me out. I like my coffee with two sugars in it. High heels and my jewelry dripping. Drinking, I get all fired up. Hey, hey, hey. Insecure, but I'm working with it. Many things that I could get rid of. Ain't nobody keep it.
Okay, so super rhythmic already, so it's gotta go something elongated, and they'll probably switch, obviously switch people, whenever the next part comes in, but this is not what I expected, like, at all.
I made a few mistakes, I regret it nightly. I broke a couple.
Or you can do that too. Literally just go up the octave. That's what's great about working with singers like this. They have this huge range to work with.
I said I wear on my sleeve. My mama always said, girl, you're troubling. And now I wonder, could you fall for a woman like me? And every time we touch, boy, you make me feel weak.
Okay, so the reason that they can do like super rhythmic is just because they're separating it out well with those little tiny sections in between like this. They leave enough space that when they go into the next section, and it's also completely different of a, the section's completely different from the previous. So, let me see, where was it? Like that.
Away and sit on the couch, or we could just go out for the evening.
It's a little bit of just normal autotune on there, like you can tell because of the way she does the evening. She's dead on, but because she's going in between two notes there, autotune doesn't know 100% what to do, and so it kind of like tries to adjust between those two, and it's not quick enough, so you get this weird sound. Listen. We could just go out for the evening. Here it almost sounds unnatural just a little bit, so it's just kind of an artistic thing. Plus, a lot of times, people just kind of throw autotune on just to fix the little tiny things that might, you know, show up here and there. It's nothing big. With a little bit of love drunk in the middle, where they get down to our favorite song. I made a few mistakes, I regret it nightly. I broke a couple hearts and I wear on my sleeve. My mama always said, go your trouble. Hear how there's like a lingering little synth in the top just to kind of create a little bit of tension? It's just that high one, and it's a lot higher, it's very thin, so it your brain picks up on it just a little bit more than it normally would. You don't even really 100% register that it's there, but it's there, and it's just making you feel a little bit tense so that it leads up into the next section extremely well and gives you that release. And now I wonder, could you fall for a woman like me? And every time I touch, boy, you make me feel weak. I can tell you. And see, they cut it, so now it feels just a little bit better, but they brought in the drums a little bit to replace it. You always have to, when you take something out, replace it with something else, unless you're cutting everything for a new section. And I think it's so sweet. Also notice that there was like zero bass at all in any of those sections until you hit this chorus. That's what gives it the oomph that it needs. Woman like me, yes, a woman like me. Soon as I brush up on them, I can tell they like me. You have that nice, like, dirty bass underneath, too, there. See, that's different from the sub. You have, like, an actual bass, like, DI input, which is a direct input bass there that's just kind of fixed up a little bit. And the chorus is probably a mix between a sub and that. What the ice me, tell them that's a bad trainee, bitch, in your area. But the more bad bitches, then the more merrier. Baddie, see my life into the right, a little scarier. Dude, boy, tell me, can you handle all this dairy, yeah? A million, I'm getting my billion. Greatest of all time, cause I'm a chameleon. And also notice how she switches her rhythm, like, every few sections, or not every few sections, but every couple bars. Nikki will switch her rhythm up. That way, it feels like it's not just the same all the way across, you know? Switch it up for every era, I'm really bomb. These bitches really wanna be Nikki, I'm really mom. Apple cut the check, I want all this money. 7 Up, go grip the tech, and leave all this bloody. It's the queen and little mix skated on them. Also, her vocal has, like, they really push like the high frequencies on it. You can tell because, like, and this is something interesting. If you start listening for it, your ear will start picking up on it, so will your brain. But like, it almost sounds like her S's are really, really defined, and so are like basically the top end, like the highs in her voice. So they call it like sibilance. So there's like a lot of sibilance in that. My daddy is Indian. You know what I mean? Curry. It's almost harsh. Very Ariana, like that, whatever it was. Let me pull it back. I gotta hear it again. Yeah, that made a few mistakes. Actually, who all is in this? Who's in this band? I need to know. Because is this like a power band or something? I gotta look it up really quick. I'll wait till the end of the song. Okay, it's X Factor. She sounded like Demi Lovato there really hard with her basically, like, the formats on her voice, like, what she was, the way she was making her words. Listen. so sweet. Spending every night on the conversation. It's the tone. It really and truly, it's the tone there in her note choices. Still I want it, could you fall for a woman like me? For a woman like me. Like me,
like me. A woman like me. Young money.
Nice delay at the very end there, and the I can't even do those. Yeah, I can only do it like with the back. But anyways, also super interesting, like the vocal distortion that they have on there, which was not like that proximity effect. It was a real like actual distortion on those vocals, and there was so much going on at the end. Okay, so let's go to Think About Us. When you're dancing in the club and the nights are getting hard, do you think about us? Super hard piano, which because this is like not ballady, it's not soft, it's not intimate, you know, you want to choose that hard piano with like maybe a big verb on it or something. And there's actually a lot of the lows have been cut out of that one as well. So it gives it an even like harsher tone, but it's just very indicative of like a power song, if that makes sense. I'm trying to think of a better word than ballad, but it's like a power song. Brown, do you think about us? Do you think about us? A banger. Yeah. Think about you. Ooh. When I'm up in my hotel room. Need your love, don't know what I'm gonna do. My body's so hot, babe, I'm missing you. One touch is all I want. I call my girls, we go down. That was a very weird transition into this, and yeah, I'm not gonna pull it back, but it almost caught me a little bit off because it was like, it's so, the beat changed so much to like this, like swung, like reggaeton beat kind of thing. It's just almost weird, but it works. I mean, it works once they all come in. Also, they have very, very, very defined tones. And I mean, I can pin what artists they might listen to or like sort of be influenced by. Like this, she sounds like a little bit of Alessia Cara. Because she has that smokier, like, just a little bit more covered tone to her vocal. Wait, what was that? Is that supposed to be there? It's a weird cut. Listen. And then you pull me close. Boy, I promise I won't let go. That's why it's throwing me, because of the cut. That's weird. It's like, I don't know. I don't know how that happened or how that got past anybody, but that's weird. Now dancing in the club, and it's fire when we touch. Do you think about us? Do you think about us? When we're deeper in the crowd, can you feel my body now? That's something that's very indicative of One Direction. So first part of the chorus is just one person singing, and then on the second part of the chorus, when you do almost the exact same melody, you bring in all the harmonies and everybody else. You think about us. Whoa. Do you think about us? Whoa. Whoa. Do you think about us? Kind of want them to go up, and I want to see if they do it. I'm sure they probably will eventually. See, this is what's different with the style, and there isn't much autotune on that one. You can tell because of the way she has that little vibrato at the end, but like, she definitely has her own defined style. Like, she might have the same sort of tone as like Alessia Cara or somebody else, but like, I'm assuming this is the same person that was on the last verse. But the style, the delivery is so much different. You don't even know all the things I won't do. Hear how that do. Yeah, there it was. That little vibrato at the very end. It doesn't have that weird sound like it did in the first song. Need your love, me and my baby. You put your hand on my waist. that's what I was talking about with the Ariana thing, because like she opens up her vocal there too, big time, which is what she needs to. And you can just tell how good of a singer she is, because it's a little bit more closed, and then when she goes into those high notes, it opens.
And so, then you pull me close.
You can hear on that close, it almost has like an A to it.
I promise I won't.
Also, they use that right there as the intro, which is the chorus. One of the best things you can possibly do is if you have a killer chorus, just throw it at the very beginning of a song and hook people in like that. Because you only have 8 seconds to pull people before they skip, you know? So, like, basically, you're not bringing all the, you know, pulling all the tricks out of the bag right off the bat, but what you're doing is maybe like a stripped down version of it. Or a lot of times you can use the pre-chorus as your intro, and that will kind of give people something to hang on to, so that when that comes back around, it's familiar to them.
Do you think about us when we're deeper in the crowd? Can you feel my body now? Do you think about us? Whoa. Do you think about us?
I always talk about Nas. Nas are one of the greatest things ever, because it's like, it applies to every single language in the world. It doesn't mean anything, and it's easy for everybody to sing. So literally, you can just like unite people with Nas.
Think about us. I wanna know.
So you have that little white noise swell that just kind of and it cuts, and then it's just super indicative of especially pop music. Pull it up, stop it, and then you have the little vocal line. Charlie Puth, How Long is another one, which sounds exactly like Dua Lipa. Oh my gosh, what's the song Dua Lipa? Yeah, I can't remember right now. Trying, my brain's getting going. But yeah, so you bring it up, cut it, and he has that, how long has this been going on? And then you bring in the music again. Interesting too is that they're from London, from what I just saw, like X Factor, they run X Factor in London, but the music is very like it's very Latin. It's just it's interesting to me, but it's cool. Okay, let's keep going. Let's go to Strip.
Take off all my makeup, cause I love what's under it. Rub off all your words, don't give up, I'm over it. You got a lot this way, yeah, you know I love all of this. Finally.
Super, super, super dry. Nothing on their vocals at all. This is a really good thing to listen to if you are curious as to what maybe like reverb is. Cause you can tell that there's absolutely nothing. It sounds like they're dead up front. There's nothing on it. And so let's see if they, or what they end up putting on them.
Naked sexy is when I'm covered in. You say I am pretty, but I say I'm beautiful. It's my committee. Say we too provocative. Still look at me, look at me, look at me. Ah, come for my girls, you blind. Daily mirror, my yellow noche. I don't know you nothing. Nah, I don't give a.
Also, what's really interesting is the little formants on that, like, or not the formants, the transients on that kick, because you can hear them popping. It's almost like they have them and they had them pasted, like, together in like, Logic Pro or whatever they were using, and then didn't, like, you have to kind of fade them into each other so they don't, like, it almost sounds like it's skipping in between, and that's where you kind of get that pop from. Or, there's a couple other ways you can get it, but that's generally where that comes from.
Not anymore. If you got little boobs, love it. If you got a big ass grab it. If you got no big rugged, push your life, go get it if you want it. Up in the mirror like, oh yeah. Loving my figure like, oh yeah. When I'm slimmer, I'm thick, I'm like, oh yeah. Swear I'm making them like, ah, yeah. Take off all my makeup.
This is fun. funny, this is exactly like a song that I just wrote that's going on my EP. It's called Dirty Laundry. And the chorus has this, like, let's see. I don't know if this is in tune or not, but, like, small snippet. It goes like this. And it's the same concept. It's like, I just want you for who you are underneath it all, but it kind of has that sort of sexy undertone. I don't have a capo here, so I'm just gonna have to sing it low. But, like, the chorus has this. I guess I can go, like, falsetto. Come on, or I'm gonna miss you. Like dirty laundry, I gotta know what your toothbrush looks like next to my semester. You down like dirty laundry, baby. Like that kind of a thing, you know? It's actually in a higher key, so I don't normally have to go falsetto there, which is why it felt weird at first. But yeah, keep an eye out for that. Got the music video coming out too, stoked.
I love what's under it. Wrap off all your words, don't give up, I'm over it. Jiggle all this way, yeah, you know I love all of this. Finally love me naked, sexiest woman, confident. Strip is getting good, my body out of control. Strip, baby, I know what you love.
Call and Response, it's been 4 songs and I have not mentioned Call and Response, and I'm sort of proud of myself, but a little upset. So definitely, tons of Call and Response right there. You have the little, like, pull it back for a second. You have the main vocal, and then you have the little.
Baby, I know what you love. I'm on my heart. This trip, gotta do what you want. If they love it or they don't.
Oh,
I know you already.
It's on a weird offbeat too. Doom.
Strip, strip.
Yeah.
Love you wanna. Don't give it damn, it's a minimum.
It's a really cool little transition there with like a pitched down vocal as well. That's my mom. She likes to leave her phone on loud all the time.
It's the skin that I'm in, yeah, I get from my mama. I'm a woman, don't test me. Baby, I'm growing, my stretchers are sexy. I don't know you enough. No, I don't give a not anymore. Here we got a little booze.
Even the that was kind of a thing.
Big ass grabbing. If you got an arm, big rocket.
And there's that distortion on the vocal again. I guess they like using that. Who produced these? I gotta look. Show credit. Come on. Show me. Oh, wow. A lot of people. Okay. So another thing. On a lot of these songs, especially ones like this, you end up... Well, actually, it's probably the girls as well. I'm sure it is. What are their names? I know I'm going off on some little tangents here, but I gotta learn. I'm curious. Okay, so yeah. It is them. So 4 of the writers are them. But then there's 3 more writers. It's almost like, I'll show you one after this, that's really kind of crazy.
Take off all my makeup, cause I love what's under it. Rub off all your words, don't give up, I'm over it. You got a lot this way, yeah, you know I love all of this.
Finally. And see, that's the same kick from the very beginning, and it almost still has the same little transient on it with the little, almost like, click to it. But they've added the lows back into it, the low frequencies.
You gotta love who you are. Don't let social media tear you apart. HBIC, I'm head Benji.
That's cool too. Take it halftime like that, and then you can kind of jump into that. It always kind of feels like it's doing this. And it's just a really nice contrast from where they were prior to this, like the rhythm contrast.
I'm ready and I got 100 bars. I don't care if you got 100 cars. I don't care if you got 100 mil. Cause even if you had 100 deals, that money won't buy you what confidence will. Skirt, pull it with the drip got juice.
And there's the change again, right back to the full, like, just straight full time. Like 4 on the floor kind of a thing. And the rhythm of the vocal changes as well.
I'm so serious. Little mix in the mix, period. Still a cover girl, even with no makeup. Live your best life, even with your 8 cups. I ain't gotta act, I just gotta be me. Put me on the track, I'ma ride like Kiki. Take off all my makeup, cause I love what's under it. Rub off all your words, don't give up, I'm okay.
You can hear how much compression is on those vocals too, which the compression is basically like, best way to describe it, because it's a weird concept, is like you put a compressor maybe on something if you want to you almost want to keep it, like, dynamically the same. This is one use of it. There's a ton of other uses, but, like, the primary use is to almost, like, you don't want to squash the sound, but bringing up, like, the volume from the very bottom and bringing down the volume from the very top. So anytime it goes up here, like, the compressor will just kind of push the volume down. Anytime it's too low or too soft, it'll bring it up. So everything comes to right about here. But you can hear on her, like, on her little vocal fries how, like, clean they are, and they're almost the exact same tone and volume as, like, the rest of her vocal, and that's how you know.
Jiggle all this way, yeah, you know I love all of this. Finally love me naked, sexiest when I'm confident. Take off all my makeup, cause I love what's under it. Rub off all your words, don't give up, I'm over it. Jiggle all this way, yeah, you know I love all of this. Finally love me naked, sexiest when I'm strip.
All right, cool. Like I said, this is so much different than what I expected, 100%. It's also because, like, I was thinking sort of like a cappella group, which they're not. My vocal coach was in an all a cappella rock group. They, like, toured the world, did all this stuff. Amazing singer. That is the one person that I've ever heard singing literally just like Justin Timberlake, butter, every single time. Never misses a note. I don't think I've ever heard him miss anything. Everything is so clean and, like, perfect. He was also on Broadway. He was in Les Mis, and his wife was in Cats, original cast, which is really cool. So yeah, shout out to Kevin and Amy. Okay, so Monster in Me.
Beautiful creatures, you and me. Every time that we touch a stranger, there's a spark of smiling chemistry.
Okay, there you go. Pop thing. Same line, little tail.
Beautiful liar, drowning deep.
Actually, it's not really the same line. That's more like, I think, ABC. Yeah.
Right now we fight and it's not like hell, but it feels like heaven between the sheets. Every time we let go, we're screaming, I go for more. Why don't we kill each other slowly? What can I say, baby? What can I do? The monster in me.
Okay, they're saving that. I know they are. Otherwise, either that or they're going to do it like right here where they just bring it up just to another little level, because that's almost where I wanted to go. But it's a good thing to save until maybe the end.
You. Hold me. Squeeze a little tighter till we can't breathe.
Also, notice the snares. One snare, and this is always indicative of pop music, like one snare, the first one, is a little bit closer, then the second one is farther back. That way it feels like it's always moving, always changing.
Baby, what can I do? The monster in me, there's a monster in you. Monster in me.
Response.
Beautiful killer.
See, hear how, like, forward the vocal comes on that verse as opposed to where it was on the chorus as well. As she comes in, it felt like it was kind of far away. The beautiful monster in me. And then it comes forward. Bad and a killer. Like, it's not even. That's the best way I can explain it. Yeah. Can't really do that here just because it's a camera.
Just a single kiss and a miss, but will you go and I can never see?
Elongated, elongated, then rhythmic.
Beautiful fire, love the heat.
That's what it is.
Mm-hmm. Every night we fight and it's hot like hell, but I love the way that you make me scream. And every time I let go, I cry and I'll beg more.
Taylor Swift. That's a, that's where I got that from. Is that Soon You'll Get Better? I don't know what that is. It's something. It's very similar, but I know this came out first. But I was also going to say, I can't remember. I'll come back.
Touch me. Why don't we kill each other slowly? What can I say? Baby, what can I do? The monster in me, there's a monster in you.
Cool. So she ends her breath and you cut the music as well almost with her. That way it feels like like the vocalist and the music are almost one, which is what you want from it. The music is there to back the melody more than anything. So follow what the vocal does and what the vocal wants to do. The melody is the driver, you know.
Every moment we spend turning from friends to enemies and fighting to hold on to each other. Every second we
call and response, call and response. There's so many things in this that I'm hearing, like other melodies, like places I kind of want them to take it, and they go a different way, which is cool because it sort of gives you, it doesn't meet your expectation 100%, but it still gives you the release that you want. But still, like, there's a couple of things, like, I probably would have done just a little bit differently. And they saw a chance to do it, so.
The hell that we both made for each other, but it's all of a war. Louder we are, crying for more. I know it's so wrong, but baby, just touch me. Why don't we get each other slowly?
The melody I wanted, the monster in you, or the
hold me, squeeze a little tighter.
What I was doing earlier, I wanted it to do the steps up and then they'll bring it up and then kind of maybe fall down. Vocoder on the bottom of that one. I forgot to show you guys because I was just looking at the credits. What I was going to show you earlier, when it comes to writers on songs, it's kind of crazy. A lot of times you think that it's just like the maybe the artist that writes it, but like Liam Payne, which giving him a video very soon, I promised everybody that and that's coming, might not do the whole album, or I might just do a couple songs. In fact, if you guys want to just give me like what you think the best songs are on that album, maybe give me 5. I'll do it like that, you know, and I can do Strip That Down too, because I love that song. But that's the one I'm talking about right now. Get this. This is how many people wrote this song. So it was produced by Steve Mack, performed by Liam Payne and Quavo, but written by Brian Thompson, Charles William Miller, Ed Sheeran, which you can definitely tell the Ed Sheeran in that. I heard that before I even looked this up, and that's the reason I looked this up. Harold Ray Brown, Howard E. Scott, Leroy Lonnie Jordan, Lee Oscar, Liam Payne, Morris Dickerson, Orville Burrell, Quavis Marshall, which is Quavo, Ricardo Ducent, Sean Pizzonio, Steve Mack, and Sylvester Allen Thomas. That's how many people worked on that or wrote that song. It's absolutely crazy, and I know there's more like that too. I think there's a couple Britney Spears songs that are like that big time, but Max Martin obviously took head on those. Okay, so let's go to Joan of Arc. So you have a synth with like all the bass taken out of it, basically all the lows taken out of it. And then you bring the bass in and look what it does. You have that contrast. You set it up. That's the tone that I keep saying reminds me of Demi Lovato. And man, I feel like that. Yeah. Joan of Arc, Queen of Hearts, yeah. We did the octave, but like, you're not gonna get the idea of it. It's a beautiful electric piano under that. I'm gonna pull it back for a second. And that's why you have that just like soft, subtle R&B feel there with that, because of that electric piano. And then you have like a little bit of a harsher vocal, and that's why they've sort of pushed the highs on the vocals a little bit more, maybe like mid to high.
Oh, you want that feminist tip?
And then bass.
Hell yeah, I am.
I don't need a man. If I'm loving you, it's cause I can.
So if you listen to these different sections and like pull out the very specific qualities of them, you can tell why they why they're in balance with each other through the way that they contrast with each other.
I don't want you cash. I put my old rock on my head. I put my old rock on my head. I put my old rock on my head. I don't need a man. If I'm loving you, it's just like him. Make way for the G-O-D-D-E-S-S-S. Spend no enemies in this dress.
Now you have the little like organic instruments in the back, like Jack Antonoff uses all the time, just like very, I always want to use like cups, like that kind of a thing. I don't have anything else metal around me, but basically it's just like you pan them both to two sides. It's very like Pharrell, like happy, or no, not happy, but like Robin Thicke, blurred lines. Yeah, very Robin Thicke blurred lines.
So feel sexy, fan of myself, I'm standing myself. I love me so much, I put my hands on myself. Fan of myself, I'm standing myself.
Another thing too, the runs are very tasteful. I personally cannot stand it when people do nothing but runs the whole song. Most of these runs are extremely tasteful and they serve the song, because the whole purpose is to serve the song and get the emotion out. You know what I mean? It's not necessarily about how good you are at anything. Because the runs, almost if they're excessive, ends up being like that jazz musician or, you know, that guitarist or like that bassist or like the drummer even. Actually, the drummer is a little bit harder to do that with. No, not really. That can definitely happen, seeing it. But, like, where you just do way, 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 way too much instead of just playing what's simple and what works, you know? Simplicity, most of the time, is going to get you so much farther than being extremely complex about something.
Yeah.
Hell yeah, I am!
I don't need a man. If I'm loving you, it's cause I can.
Yes, I can.
I don't want your cash.
Let your thighs get sore.
I don't need a man. If I'm loving you, it's cause I can.
Cause I can.
I don't want you care. I put my own rock on my head. I put my own rock on my head. I put my own rock on my head. I don't need a man. If I'm loving you, it's cause I can.
And that, just in her vocal line, it's just a lot of call and response. You know what I mean? The, I don't need a man. Up on my own, back on my, like that kind of a thing. It's just the back and forth, the back and forth.
I don't need a man. If I'm loving you, it's cause I can.
Cause I can.
I don't want you cash. I put my own rock on my head. I put my own rock on my head. I put my own rock on my head.
Also notice that that sub and the little are playing the exact same thing. It's just the sub is playing the, obviously, the octave below, or a couple octaves below.
I don't need a man. If I'm loving you, it's cause I can.
Alright. Okay, so. Love a girl, right? I feel like this is gonna be a slow song. But I'm probably wrong. Nope. Definitely wrong. Every single time I think it's gonna be a slow song, it's not.
Oh, that boy so scandalous. Yeah, he brought my girl's heart and he was on the net. He was cheating on the low in the club all night. Never seen my girl so messed up, yeah. Out with his boys in the hip-hop spot. She all alone wondering if he's coming home or not. For the whole damn year I was wiping up her tears. He was living the vida loca.
Nice, I love it. See, it's still so, like, Latin-driven. I mean, I don't know if they come from, like, Latin families or anything like that. I'm not gonna read up on it all right now. I might later. But, also, the Living the Vida Loca. I love it. I loved Ricky Martin when I was a kid. My mom used to just listen to that all the time. I think everybody did though. Cause she'd have better seen whatever happened to you, and that's the truth. Don't make me have to let you. And actually, that like electric guitar, that distorted electric guitar, is very like Maluma. No, and now we're cool. But if I ever hear you mess this up, I'm coming after you. So don't you treat her wrong. Yeah, you better love a girl right, baby. Cause you bound to lose. So now they brought on the acoustic guitar in the back just a little bit, give it a little bit of change. Cause even these songs, they're not very like, the sections aren't super defined. They kind of do this, and they sort of just lead into each other a little bit more than what am I saying, like lead into each other. They kind of like, the line between them is blurred a little bit. Notice how that guitar was playing like off of the basic melody of the song as well, like a melodic motif kind of thing. I don't know 100% if that's the right use of melodic motif, but these are things that like I know what I use them for and I know what I think they are, and that's kind of how I work. But yeah, I would call it melodic motif because it's very similar to like the primary melody of it. It feels like a play off of it. She mean the whole world to me. All she want is your loyalty. She want better, she don't want another mistake. You better not risk it, cause in my eyes all I'm seeing is a queen. If you do it wrong, just believe she'll be living la vida loca. You know I'll be watching you, cause she's the baddest thing to ever happen to you. And that's the truth, don't make me have to hurt ya. Hear how the bass is almost like perfectly in line with the, in terms of his mix. It's morning, people continue to come by. Or he sees probably another dog, maybe. That's probably what it is. Anyways, that bass is like perfectly in line with the acoustic, so it almost feels like they're one instrument. Right now we're cool. Right now we're but cool. But if I ever hear you mess this up, I'm coming after you. So don't you treat her wrong. Yeah, you better love a girl right, baby. Cause you bad. I mean, it's changing so much, but like the lines are definitely blurred between each section. Like it doesn't 100% feel like that's the difference between something like this and maybe like One Direction, they didn't do a lot of like vocal runs, they didn't do anything like that, which when you when you're getting lyrics across and you're getting like the basics of like a song, you know, the essence of a song across, the more that you move around, the more confusing it is to the listener. So like that's why if you have like very static melodies that aren't moving a ton, you can put more lyrics in because you're conveying more information and it's not too much, it's not overload on the person that's listening. They can understand it, they can feel it because that's what their brain is like, I'm gonna focus on this. But when there's a lot going on, it's difficult to kind of, it can kind of feel a little muddied, you know? Much is going on there, like I probably would have just pulled it down to like a main like primary melody, but that's also like just me and my like production style, you know, it's different for everybody and it's also different based on taste. See, like that, they're just very good at harmonies too, and so I know they're accentuating that big time. Okay, so let's go to American Boy. Singing, 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 ooh la, he breaks my heart. I know he thinks about when he plays guitar. And ooh la la,
on my American boy. When I was out in California, he was playing in a band and she was dancing on the stage. And he says that I'm the one, but she's the one that got away. And he never knew her real name. Oh, and I don't mean to get so caught up in.
There's the change in the rhythm as well.
Oh, and I don't mean that and that and that and that. No. You're about all the things you say. Oh, and I don't mean to be jealous.
There's a little bit of tune on that last A. You can hear it because everything gets really perfect and really flat. Yeah. Here, it switches almost a little too suddenly.
Oh, I don't mean to be jealous. It's just careless me, but I'm a striving man. Singing, 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 ooh la, he breaks my heart. I know he thinks I'm better when he plays guitar. And ooh la la, my American boy. Singing, 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 ooh la la, he breaks my.
Curious about something. Because the ooh la la's you don't hear very often, and this reminds me big time of, I'm going to take a picture of who produced this. Because these are different people than the other one. And this is written, actually not by any of them, this is written by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I believe, other artists, hold on. Or other songwriters. Yeah. Interesting. Okay, I'm going to look this up.
I know he thinks it's better when he plays guitar.
I was talking about Senorita because it reminds me of Senorita a little bit, and it's that actually, I just looked it up, they're not the same writers, but Senorita had 9 writers on it.
Needed to ask, I wanna know if you're at home, and if you're at home, maybe I am alone, answer your phone, oh baby, low, low.
I do want to say one more thing actually about that since I'm on that, and I know this is slightly off topic from the song, and I'll get back to the song, and I'll probably pull it back a little bit so I can listen again, but if you're writing at home, and you're producing at home, and you're doing anything like that, don't fall into the trap of comparing yourself to everybody else that's out there and the songs that are out there. Even though technically that is what you're competing against, you're really and truly just competing against yourself. And if you can't compete with that, they literally had 9 writers on Senorita. Like, there's like 6 or 7 on this one. There was like 15 on, you know, Strip You Down, that kind of a thing. When it's just one person, trust me, I know. I'm writing an EP right now. It's very, very, very difficult to do it all on your own and not have anybody to bounce things off of. So you can't compare yourself to other artists like that. It's a very, it's a bad rabbit hole to go down. Very bad rabbit hole. Been there, done that. And you just kind of have to become comfortable with yourself too. Same thing with the quality of sound that you're putting out and everything like that. You can work hard and you can do your best to make it that way, but like, or make it as good sounding as possible and as professional sounding as possible, but you're still not in a, you know, multi-million dollar studio. It's so difficult to get that sound as well. Okay, so pull it back a little bit.
American boy, always my American boy. So I wanna know who's on your phone, making me paranoid, making me bad, making me sad, making me crazy, making me feel like I needed to ask. I wanna know if you're at home.
That's what I'm saying, their harmonies are perfect. You hear how she's just sitting so well in that high harmony.
Oh, maybe I am alone, answer your phone, oh baby, la la la. You get so caught up and insecure about all the things you say. Oh, I don't mean to be jealous, it's just jealous me, but I'm a striving man. Singing, 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 ooh la la, it breaks my heart. I know it takes a battle when he plays guitar. And ooh la la, my American boy. Singing, singing, singing.
The call and response with just a little, this is what they do. Their call and response is, their responses aren't really necessarily for a crowd to sing. It's more, you know, it's more runs, you know, that kind of a thing. But it's still a call and response, which is why it pulls your ear.
Yeah.
out of that, out of the main music in the back, like the, got it.
He thinks about a honey bass guitar, ooh la la, he breaks my heart, he do.
La-las are the good response, you know what I mean? Or that's the good call and response, because it gives, you know, the audience something kind of to sing to when you do this stuff live. That American boy too has a really nice, it's almost like American girl. Actually, it's American boy is easier to say phonetically, so it works so well as like a as a title and like a main hook in a song too. Okay, so last song for today, and then we'll cut, and I'm gonna do part two either later this week or next week. I'm not sure yet when I'll be posting the second part, but it will be very, very, very soon, like in the next week. Okay, so let's see, we're on Told You So. Ooh, interesting choice.
Da dum, da dum. Be honest. How are you feeling, girlfriend?
You can hear a little bit of that autotune on it again because of the vibrato.
Been crying again. Just give it some time. Breathe out. See, I'm happy. That boy was just playing pretend. We said that you wouldn't listen, but finally you found out that he's never gonna love you like we do. But please, he's never gonna find no one like you. No. Girl, just come round mine tonight.
Now just the back strum on that acoustic is giving it a little bit more, which either they're like ducking the acoustic sound just a little bit with like a weird things like compressors like on a bus or something like that, or they've used like a little bit of automation to like pull that tone out, or it might even be the way that it's mixed, like the frequencies they've cut out of the guitar so that just that kind of pushes itself forward a little bit.
Put the kettle on, talk about how he's not the one I've told you. But I'm never gonna say I told you so.
Be honest, his best friend was hotter than him. His jokes were just lacking content. But darling, you're better.
I love the yas. The yas are really cool. Like, those are super nice, light, airy notes. They've cut, like, pretty much everything out of them, and they kind of push them back a little bit. That way it almost feels like, okay, this person takes the front, push them back so they can do, like, the responses, and then you switch, you know? Classic.
Someone who lies and cheats to set the scene is every week in every single club we've been in. He's with another girl again. Now you know that he's never gonna love you like we do.
You know, like, I've said this a lot for this one, but my only thing is, I wish that they would, like, they have the massive bag of tricks, and I just feel like that's I've said this a couple times, like, a hole to go down in, you know what I mean? Like, if you have this bag of tricks, like, save them for the right spots, like, wait until later in the song and give people chills, because when you do it a lot, people sort of lose interest, you know what I mean? Although, they've done incredibly well, so I guess people haven't lost interest, but like, it could probably just be a little bit more dynamic if they did just hold them back a little bit and then release it, you know what I mean? Like, do some of those runs and do some of those bigger things, like, later in the song, instead of so early, you know. And I know they have like these huge ranges and everything, but like, just wait and let them out, you know, build that tension and then give their release and everyone be like, oh my gosh, yes, there it is. Although it's also super, super indicative of R&B. Now that I don't know how I haven't picked up on that 100% yet. And that's just what you do in R&B, like all the time. You just move around. That makes more sense. That's probably their background. Yeah.
I'm never gonna say I told you so. I'm never gonna say I want you. But I'm just so glad that you know that you know that you know.
Don't just come on my tonight.
Put a ton of verb on the end of that, like, little, she didn't even go to a whistle voice, it's just really, really, really high falsetto, or not falsetto, but head mix, no, head voice, oh my gosh, like,
I'll hold you, I'll hold you, we can pop the kettle on, talk about how he's not the one,
he's not the one.
Okay. All right. I mean, these girls are insanely talented. This is nuts. So I'm stoked for part two. Yeah, I'm sure there's, like, everybody's going to be like, there's even better songs in part two. That's what happened with Zayn Icarus Falls. But, you know, yeah, I'm excited. All right, well, thanks for hanging around. And I know it was a little bit shorter today, but filming, like, 10 things today. So getting through it all. But thank you again, and I'll catch y'all later.